Hello, folks. I just wanted to record this quick little bit to put in before we start the showcase, just to help contextualize proceedings a little bit. This showcase is specific to a module that I have in college. April 2nd, 2020, that was the night that I was supposed to be performing the following showcase on stage in front of an audience. But then, of course, the pandemic had other plans. And I have since been sitting on an appropriate backup plan to make sure that I get it out there, which is the form of a stylized short film. It would be a shame if I did not get this showcase out there in some way, shape, or form. Like, I would have been gutted if it had turned out that way. I didn't want it to turn out that way at all. I am incredibly, incredibly proud of the work that I put into the following three pieces, and I just could not let all that time and effort go unseen. So thankfully, here we are. I would like to extend a massive special thank you to my mentor for this showcase, Mr. Johnny Hanrahan. Johnny, thank you for everything, and thank you for being such a brilliant mentor to me. Thank you for everything, sir. So, without any further ado, it's time to ring in the new year by doing what I do best. I hope you all enjoy it, and I shall see ye when I see ye. Take care. I like plays. The good ones. Shakespeare. I like Titus Andronicus the best. It's sweet. Incidentally, did you know that you were talking to an artist? 'Cause I like to do special things to my victims. Things that are creative. Of course, it requires knowledge and pride in your work. For example, a decapitated head can continue to see for approximately 20 seconds. So when I have one that's gawking, I hold it up so that it can see its body. It's a little something extra that I threw in for no added charge, although I must admit, it makes me chuckle every time. Life is fun. It's a wonderful life, in fact. For some. So there I was. So awfully dead in that electric chair. I didn't like it. Would you? It's upsetting. There was still so much killing left to do, and there I was in the void without a body until along came one of them. The cruel ones. The master. He thought my work should continue in this body. In
this body in particular, in fact. Oh, let's call it revenge. It's a certain matter of an exorcism, I think, in which your friend, Father Karras, helped expel certain parties from the body of the child. Said parties were none too pleased, to say the least. Not the very least. So the master devised this pretty little scheme to get back, to create a stumbling block, a scandal, a horror to the eyes of all men seeking faith. Using the body of this saintly priest as an instrument for, well, my work. But the main thing is the torment of your friend, Father Karras, as he watches while I rip and cut and mutilate the innocent, his friends, again and again, and on and on. He is inside with us. He will never get away. His pain won't end. Oh, gracious me, was I raving? Please forgive me, I'm mad.
When shall I climb to the top of that same hill?
You do climb it now. Look how we labor.
Methinks the ground is even.
It's horrible steep. Hark. Do you hear the sea?
No. Truly.
Why then, your other senses grow imperfect by your eyes' anguish.
So may it be indeed. Methinks thy voice is altered, and thou speakest in better phrase and matter than thou didst.
You're much deceived. In nothing am I changed but in my garments.
Methinks you're better spoken.
This is the place. Stand still, sir. How fearful and dizzy 'tis to cast one's eyes so low. The crows and choughs that wing the midway air show scarce so gross as beetles. Halfway down hangs one that gathers samphire, a dreadful trade. Methinks he seems no bigger than his head. The fishermen that walk upon the beach appear like mice. And yon tall anchoring bark diminished to her cock. Her cock. A buoy almost too small for sight. The murmuring surge that on the unnumbered idle pebble chafes cannot be heard so high. I look no more, lest my brain turn and the deficient sight topple down headlong.
Set me where you stand.
Give me your hand. You are now within a foot of the extreme verge. For all beneath the moon, I would not leap upright. Let go of my hand. Here, friend. A purse. In it a jewel, well worth a poor man's taking. Fairies and gods prosper with thee. Now, go thou further off, bid me farewell, and let me hear thee going.
Fare you well, good sir.
With all my heart. Why I trifle thus with his despair is done to cure it. Oh, you mighty gods. He kneels. And through your eyes, shake patiently my great affliction off. If I could bear it longer, and not fall to quarrel with your great opposeless wills. My snuff and loathed part of nature doth burn itself out. If Edgar live, oh, bless him. Now, fellow, fare thee well.
I lay down across her with my face in her breasts and my hand on her. We lay there without moving, but under us all moved, and moved us gently, up and down and from side to side. Past midnight, never knew.
Just finished listening to that stupid bastard I took myself for 30 years ago. Hard to believe that I was ever as bad as that. Well, thank God that's all done with anyway. The eyes she had. Everything there. Everything. All the light and dark and famine and feasting of the ages. Yes! Let that go. Take his mind off his homework. Jesus. Well, maybe he was right. Maybe he was right. Nothing to say.
not a squeak. What's a year now? The sour cud and the iron stool. Reveled in the word spool. 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 Happiest moment of the past half million. Seventeen copies sold, of which 11 at trade price to free circulating libraries beyond the seas. It's getting known. £1.06 or something. £8, I have little doubt. Crawled out once or twice before the summer was cold. Dreamed of dreams and burning to be gone. Not a soul. Last fancies. Keep them under. Scalded the eyes out of me reading Effie again. A page a day with tears again. Effie. Could have been happy with her. Up there in the Baltic, in the pines and the dunes. Effie. Could I? Could she? Fanny came in a couple of times. Bony old ghost of a whore. Couldn't do much, but I suppose it was better than a kick in the crotch. How do you manage it at your age? She said. And I told her that I'd been saving up for her all my life. Went to Vespers once, like when I was in short trousers. Now the day is over, night is drawing nigh. Shadows of me. Steal across the sky. Went to sleep and fell off the pew. Sometimes I wondered in the night if a last effort mightn't. Oh, finish your booze now. Carry on with this drivel in the morning.
or leave it at that. Leave it at that.
Perhaps my best years are gone, when there was a chance of happiness. But I wouldn't want them back. Not with the fire in me now. No. I would not want them back.